Okay, so I've done a few FM22 rebuilds already this year, and I'm back doing another one. This time though, we're going over to Spain to manage Villarreal. And now what I've done with the last two is given myself 5 years to win a league or the Champions League. This time I'm going to give myself 3 years just to win the Champions League. Simply because Villarreal just start in the Champions League and have a better squad. Also, the domestic league in Spain is easier to win than a domestic league in England, which is why that's not counted for the same as a Champions League. Anyway, with all that said, I'm going to now play FM. Okay, so here we are at Villarreal, and I've done my first transfer window. So I jump over here to transfer history. I can show you who I've brought in. And I've only brought in two players, but they're good players. First of all, Alexander Isak. Look at that. Just a brilliant striker in FM. Only 21 years old. It's the real deal. So as soon as Isak, I think it's what, 40 million, not all up front was available, I just went and got him. And then next up, Nicholas Schuler. He only has a year left on his contract when you start your save. So I was able to pick him up for 13 million. Again, another steal. Again, I could have waited till January to get the like pre-contract on a free. But I kind of wanted him now. So I got him now. Now for sales, I just made the two. Manu, not brilliant with the old name pronunciation. He went for 12 million. And Ruben Penna, he went for 5 and a bit million. That's how we got the funds for the other two transfers. Anyway, with all that said, hopefully this year we can at least qualify for the Champions League. That is the bare minimum I wanted this year. So let's skip forward and see if we can do it. Hey there, this percentage of people who watch the videos aren't subscribed. So if you enjoy the videos, make sure to subscribe so you know when they come out. Anyway, enjoy the rest of the video. Okay, bang, through to the end of the year, a season played, and we won La Liga. If I come over to competitions, it wasn't all success. We were out in the group stage of the Champions League. And I'll just show you our group in that. We had Man United, AC Milan, and Ajax. Okay, we probably should have done better in our games against Ajax, because that could have sent us through, because our only win in the group was against Milan. But still, no matter how you twist this, that's a hard group. But we did do the domestic double because I won the Spanish Cup. I also won the Super Cup because obviously they were in that because they beat Man United in the Europa League final last year. Yeah, but winning La Liga, it's not too tough, especially in this first year, because Real Madrid and Barcelona both don't have the best squad, and it's before they can kind of start fixing them. So I imagine both of those teams are going to get a bit better. But still, we were, what, 9 points clear at the top of this league. It was fairly easy if you look at the positions, first for a long time. And part of doing that was a bit of January business. So we made two signings. I signed Kramaric, who, because I haven't shown you the tactic yet, we're playing this 4-2-4. So I need quite a few strikers to play two strikers. So Kramaric, I think what he was, 10 million I think he was. Yeah, 10 million, just made sense. Then we also brought in Danny Ceballos. But again, another one just made sense. Decent centre mid. Played quite a bit of football, averaging over a 7. Pretty decent. But we had like no money when you last saw me. So we have funded that with quite a few sales. If we go, January starts here. So the first man out the door was one that kind of upset me, but it was Dan Juma. But the issue is, just in this game, he wasn't really good enough to get in the squad. And was it? He wanted to leave. We got a 15 million offer. I mean, that's pretty good, considering he'd played no football and just come in for 20 million. But the reason I like Dan Juma, I'm a Bournemouth fan, and he was magic to watch last year. But unfortunately, it just didn't make sense to keep him around. Next up, Etienne Capoue. He went to Brighton for, what, 2 million? I can't remember exactly. I think they might have agreed a pre-contract, and then I just sold him off for whatever they'd give us. Again, another one who's seeing, like, no minutes. Then another right-back left, like in the summer, Mario Gaspar. Again, I just think he's a guy, yeah, he's getting one La Liga game. He was getting no football. He wanted to leave. An offer came in. We sold him. Someone I didn't want to sell, but was kind of forced into sailing, Paco Alcacer. Or is it Paco? Yeah, Paco Alcacer. I'm not sure. But Spurs came in and gave us 47 million. Like, he'd been good, but I don't know if he'd been 40 million good. So obviously I couldn't turn that down. Then after that, Spurs come in for Coquelin. And again, Coquelin had been good. We come over to here, averaging under a 7. I don't know if he was 26 million good at. How old is he? 31. Yeah, it's again another one. Like, I like the player. I can't turn that money down. Then Abbey Hull went out to Newcastle for very little money. Yeah, not one I was dying to do, but the bit of money in for him off the wage bill, you know, I was fine taking that. And finally, two loans out. Ibora, who I'd rather have sold, but he'd requested a loan out earlier in the window, so I just gave it to him. 10 games, played a fair bit of football, but it's just like, he's fine. But at 34, I wanted to move him on. Then we loaned out, I don't know how to say it. I'm so sorry. But because of his contract, I think he was like a regular B team player and he got about 10 start. He was like, yeah, I don't get enough football. It was really weird because he got well over what his contract said, but I didn't want to upset him, so I just gave him the loan. Then I've done a few pre-arranged transfers. Eriksen, Tolisso and Desiglio, all on a free. And Serge Aurier will be leaving on a free at the end of the year. But I think overall, that's a very good first year. Now on to year two. All right, so it's the beginning of next season. And because of that, I've obviously done this summer's business. If I just sort from here, so we have the three free transfers I told you about. The best of which is probably Eriksen. If you look here, he has superb technicals. And he's got good enough physicals. They're not quite what you'd want, and the work rate's not as good, but I mean, those technicals are still those technicals. But then, starting off the summer business for the transfers I haven't shown you, first of all, Adam Holzek. I think that's how you say it, not sure, it's a Czech name. I can get the Adam. I know Adam's Adam, hopefully. Got a fair bit of potential. We come to his reports, a two-star player is now actually just good enough to play in this league. So for 5 and a bit million, I think that's a fine deal. Next up, Karim Adeyemi, and I think we all know how good he is. Just under £20 million, that's probably one of the higher fees I've paid for him. But even at that price, I snapped him right up. He turns into probably the best striker. It depends, it's like maybe it's him, maybe it's Mbappe, maybe it's Haaland, but he's a few years younger, so normally there'll be a couple of years where he's the best striker, and sometimes he can just get better than Mbappe and Haaland, but still, that's a very good transfer. Next up, JWP, James Ward-Prowse. I picked him up in the Villa rebuild because 20 corners, 20 free kicks, you always have a spot on my team. This time he's only 28 million. I think I paid like nearly 60 million last time. But the reason for that is because Southampton are in the Championship. They got relegated. Next up, I signed Benjamin Sesko. So I'm just raiding Salzburg at this point. But Sesko, another young striker, a bit like Adeyemi, doesn't get quite as good, but it's still another one you can get on the cheap and gets very good. And then I got, Mateus Vinha. I feel like it'd be Vinha, even though there's no reason for it to be Vinha. Either way, it's a decent left back. Got that 16 pace, 17 stamina, and 16 work rate. And for me, those are the big three in a fullback. At least if you're playing wing back attack like me, you just need him getting up and down the field relentlessly. Only the 9 million, so fairly cheap. He's a good age. Yeah, it seemed like a good deal. And to finish off the signings, I got Chris Richards in, who can just cover across the back three. He's to a decent level. He's a good age. Yeah, it was just because we were a bit thin across the back line, because we had a couple of right backs, but that right back also was our main centre half. So it was like there were players covering in other positions. So I was just like, I'll get someone who's decent in all of them. And here he is. Just the 11 million for him, which, I mean, 11 million is quite a lot for how not good he is, but I was happy to pay it. And then our final saying, Beyendir, probably not how it's said, Turkish goalkeeper out of Fenerbahce, only 17 million to a good level, good age, especially for a keeper, pretty decent. Now for the sales, because there were quite a few, as I'm sure you can guess, because we spent quite a lot of money. First of all, we sold our left back to Real Madrid for 28 million, which, to be honest, I think we've done well to get 28 million for him. Like, a good player, but yeah, he's just like a pretty good left back. 30 million in the bank, go spend that money on someone like an Adeyemi. I'm fine with that. Next up, Newcastle came in and bought our keeper for 37 million. And 37 million for a keeper, I mean, he's like a decent keeper. But it just seemed for 37 million, it was fairly obvious. And even though we got in an ever so slightly worse keeper, again, having that, what, like 20 million extra to play around with, let's just get in players like Adeyemi. Next up is Mandy, and he went to Tottenham. He only played 22 league games, right, with us, and he's been signed for 35 million. I don't know why Tottenham just keep throwing money at us. I mean, they throw a lot at us for Paco Alcácer, a lot for Francis Coquelin, and now another 35 million. And finally, for our sales, the last one we did was Jeremy Pino, and this one was quite annoying. Because you can look here, 25 million. You look 19 years old, quite good. Why would you sell him for that much? He wouldn't re-sign a new deal, and I didn't realise his release clause until it started getting talked about in the media with Man United. So basically, there was no way of re-signing him, just because of how late I noticed. I'm sure if I noticed early enough, there's a good chance I could have already, like, I could have just signed him to a new contract, new release clause, but no, I had to lose him. So I think overall, the squad's got better, even though I think at left back and goalkeeper, we've got worse, just straight up. But I think the money that we've got given for the replacements in those positions, I think has made the squad as a whole a bit better. Anyway, I guess the only way we're going to find that out is by playing through the season and seeing how the squad actually does. So I guess that's what I'm going to have to do. Okay, so the end of another season. And this time we weren't able to clinch out the title. 87 points, I think. If we go back to last season, 87. It's actually the same amount of points. It's just that Barcelona and Real Madrid got a lot better. But the way this could have gone is because you see a 4-point difference between us and Real Madrid. Schedule, scroll down. Last day we had Real Madrid. But we weren't able to clinch it up. One thing we were able to do is win the Spanish Cup. It went to extra time, but still a 2-0 win. Pretty decent. And the Champions League this year, we went out in the quarterfinal, able to knock out Juventus very convincingly, but Man United were just too much. Now for business, we did Samuel Chumas, he wanted to leave, and we could only get the 12 million for him, so he went. Chris Richards wanted to leave on loan, so I couldn't be bothered getting him upset, so I just let him go on loan. Then we brought in Sebastian, he's just a talented youngster, and Eric Garcia with a compulsion to buy. You look at the contract here, 12 million. And agreed. For other transfers agreed, a load of youngsters and Hector Bellerin. Able to pick him up on a free. He's like a decent, pacey right back. He's the type of right back we play with. It kind of just made a bit of sense. Now, and something else I want to show you. Karim Adeyemi, 41 goals. It's a bit mental. But yeah, that's how we got on this year. I'm going to go do another summer of business and update you on how the team's looking. Okay, so I've done all my transfers. And this might be my worst transfer window ever. See, if I come to registration here, you'll see we have a max salary, which is 1.7 million. And if we look at one of the players I brought in, Weston McKennie, he's on 200 grand a week. So running through the transfers, I brought in Jules Koundé, Declan Rice, Tino Livramento, Weston McKennie, Correa, as well as Justin Cliver, Patrick DePaula, and a few others on very low wages when I realised the issue. And if you look at sold, it's a lot of players. The two most significant here being Christian Eriksen, who was very good last year, and Foyth, who's been very good the whole time. Can cover centre-back and right-back very well, but he's gone now. As well as that Cramrich, Moreno, and Danny Ceballos. And if you look, I still have another 46 million, but I just can't bring anyone else in. And I have a paper-thin squad. But the first team is probably better. It's just some of the teams I'm having to put out in the cups and stuff is they're just awful. If you look here, Hector Bellerin didn't get registered. Luckily, he's not angry about it, but just, it's a mess. Anyway, hopefully just having a stronger 11 just does us a world of good in the Champions League, because that's all we really need to do. Hopefully it's enough. But I guess we'll just have to play out the season and see. Okay, so we've come to the end of this season, and we've only managed to get second in La Liga, but we've managed to get to that Champions League final. Now, looking at how we got there, a fairly easy run. Coming out the group, we got Eintracht Frankfurt, AS Monaco, and then Bayern Munich, who are quite a good side. Now, transfers-wise, in January, we didn't get up to much, just signing João Cancelo for like 100 million. And the reason for that being, we sold Nicolas Schüle for a 66 million release clause. We had 100 million in the budget. Because of the wage thing, which I'd messed up before, we could only sign one player. Schüle was mainly playing at right back. I just went out and signed the best right back that money could buy. Slight issue with that, he broke his leg. If we come over to his Villarreal career, that was after 8 games. That's probably not the best use of money I've ever had. In other competitions, we won the Spanish Cup and the Super Cup. We got runners-up. I don't think I've done a great job composing this squad, but the run that's got us to the Champions League final was a bit fortunate, so we're here now. And that Champions League final is today. And I think I've picked my team. And if you look here, it is pretty much the first 11 that plays if they're all fit. And a quick note, Alexander Isak, 43 goals. Moving on from that, let's submit this team and play Liverpool. Liverpool's team fairly changed. I was expecting just to say unchanged as they normally are with these kind of things. So, I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4 new players to that starting 11. And if we look over at Villarreal, 11. That's a lie, actually. It's 10. Anyway, hopefully the massive change I've brought in is good enough to win today. Torres into Rice. Adeyemi. Oh, I thought Isaac was going to go there, but he's still gone past this man. Ah, could have very nearly been a goal. But Ward-Prowse on this corner. There's always a chance it leads to a goal. Into the near post, and it's cleared by Van Dijk. We play forward and we lose the ball. Alexander-Arnold into Lewandowski to Salah. That was always going to be a problem. Just watching it again. Keeper could do slightly better than this. Ward-Prowse, we know how dangerous his corners are. Into the back post and it's cleared. Alisson goes long here and it goes straight to Mane. That is disappointing. That they're just able to play back to front that easily without much contention. Into Lewandowski. Oh, and Mane on the rebound. Starting to feel like today may not be our day. But at 2-0, this game's not dead. We've had a little bit. Couple of corners, you know. You've been unlucky. They like that. They're a bit motivated now. Liverpool just knocking it about nicely here. Henderson to Lewandowski to Marcus Antonio. Kluivert's tired and playing poorly. So Hulzek's going to come on for him. Declan Rice is tired and not playing brilliantly. Weston McKennie comes on. And then we kind of need a goal. So Benjamin Sesko comes on for Karim Adeyemi. Liverpool coming down this right-hand side. Firmino to Luis Diaz. And that's probably game if it counts. And it says that's a goal. Yeah, I think there's no way back into this tie for us. I say that might be the tie for us. But it looks like maybe we could have a goal here. Yes, Correa. He's given us a lifeline. 82nd minute. Only two goals behind. Maybe the dream's still on. A corner now in the 85th minute. Ward-Prowse, he's got that brilliant delivery. And it doesn't connect to any Villarreal players. But the ball comes back in. And Hulzek. And if he's kept himself onside there, we're really in this. The goal's gone to VAR. To me, he looked on. Oh, but it's not been given. Even if we grab a goal here in this 93rd minute, pretty much, I think there's just not enough time to then go and get another. Correa now squares it across. Benjamin Sesko. And that is time. Well, there we go. This is the first rebuild I've actually failed. Subscribe for more rebuild content. And again, goodbye.